So I'm very glad to be here, especially that I'm quite new to programming and new to open source. I discovered my first HTML document like 1 year and a half ago, so that's saying how new I am. But it was, I'm saying that not only to excuse myself, but also because I think it's a very important position for me, because I'm discovering things and this community with a fresh or other eye. And also because I realize I have sometimes a different approach to open source, for instance, and also to programming. And for instance, I'm really interested in, other than the licensing questions, what does it change to work in an open source spirit and to make an open source project? About open source or free fonts, as long as I'm also coming from another background, I'm caring about connections. And you probably know that the font, traditional font community is a very traditional and sometimes a paternalistic community. They have there also quite serious gender problems. And so I'm a bit in between because I'm not really a type designer, but I was interested in type design and also in what open source projects are developing. So I decided to do a blog, and it's in between. It's also a kind of a weird project because it's in between a blog, a website, and maybe something else. And it was based on the idea that I'm not interested as open source not only as a license issue, but more as a culture, and a culture in which there is a great place for collaboration and also for stories and history behind the projects. I really like an essay from Anthony Huberman, which is called Take Care, where he talks about artistic institutions and workers there performing their activities in the key of the I care instead of I know or I don't. And he talks a lot about hospitality, homage to the work of persons who inspire us, etc. And I really like to think of what I know of open source projects as performed in the key of the I share, and making it possible for others to appropriate one's work. So there is also this idea of welcoming projects and enabling a dialogue. But also sharing one's sources is giving the recipe, the instructions, the code, but not only. And I'm very interested in the fact that it could be also sharing one's references and the history or just the story behind the project. So to start talking really about this project, I wanted to talk about fonts. About their history, and I grow more and more interested in the notion of specimen in a wide way, and not only open source way, in a historical perspective. And I realized that specimen had different forms, so it evolved from single sheets displaying A, B, C to Z, posters, books, and now there is an interesting thing that are web specimen. And from the beginning, the specimen is something that uses a neutral form. For instance, the use of pangrams or false Latin or Greek texts to have a kind of exhaustivity and efficiency and to help the user choosing between different fonts, which is an approach, which is the approach usually used. But I think it's a very formal approach. And it's supposed that there is a kind of naked content that needs to find a better fitting shape. And so it makes that Usually the specimens are unreadable and sometimes also uninteresting because they're supposed to be only looked at. And I wanted to propose something that is something else than just separating forms from content, and which is something that is also very corresponding to the web practices where you have a database and a template. And I wanted to propose something in which the specimen tells a bit about the story of the font. So as long as it's an open source project, I'm also using open source specimen that already exists. For instance, a lot of projects by OSP where they tell the story of the fonts they made. And I'm doing also some graphic or more writing, like essay-like blog posts on many fonts, and trying to connect these different projects together. I did also a very it's an ongoing project, so it will keep on evolving. That's what I like about the blog project and also this notion of version. Here, for instance, you have also I like to use the reference to Wikipedia. So this is a clear citation of Wikipedia, but you can also go and edit the specimen article from this blog. And if you want to add a comment, I invite you to read this. And if you want to comment something yourself, you can go at the end of this long about and add something that I can then handcraftedly add somewhere in the blog. And I just wanted to read something just to finish, because it's really something that is present on every web font directories and many web font or foundries. It's the fact that we have almost nothing about the history of the font, and usually it's something like this, like blah blah blah, is the perfect font for body text and headlines on a website. It's modern style, suited with past characteristics of great typeface, makes it highly readable in any context. The full circle curves on many characters makes a great font to blend seamlessly with other fonts while still maintaining its uniqueness. Whether to be used for body text or headlines on a web page, is the right font for any project. So for me, I think we should care about making a font specific, and then as long as it's maybe open source project, we allow also different appropriations. But I think it's not a problem to like say clearly where fonts come from and what is the content that is brought together with it. So, thank you.